In this video tutorial, we're going to continue looking into the chart feature of LibreOffice Calc. For this tutorial, we've got sample data from a restaurant. We've got three meals, steak, pasta, and vegetarian, and three stores, store one, store two, and store three. We have grouped by the number sold on a particular night, and then the amount of income from that number sold based on the selling price. I'm going to create a chart by selecting the meals and the stores and the number sold and clicking on the chart. This is showing us that it's grouped by the meals at the bottom, steak, pasta, vegetarian. And we can see store one, store two, and store three. Store one is blue, and then we have orange for store two and yellow for store three. On our left, we see the number sold, showing the most being pasta in store one. So we can check another type of, what if we went to like line chart and lines only. I don't think this works for the purposes we're looking for, so we're going to stay with the column. And we've selected our chart type. Let's look at the data range. The data range is B4 to E7, which is our group. We have the series in columns. The first row was labeled, and the first column is labeled. So we're happy with the data range. Let's look at the data series now. In our data series, we've got data range, range for name, categories. In our data series, we've got store 1, store 2, and store 3. So in store 1, we've got our Y values, our C5 to C7, which is basically this column underneath store 1. When I look at store 2, this changes to D5 to D7. And the range for the name is D4. When I change to store 3, this changes to E4. And the data range is showing this information under column E. The categories is B5 to B7. This doesn't change when we change our data series because we always want it to be the steak, pasta, vegetarian. Now, if we go back to the data range and change this to series in rows, then we come to the data series. Now we see the steak, pasta, and vegetarian here. And the data values now are going across instead of down. Pretty simple to understand once you see it all with data. For the chart elements, just giving it a title, we're going to say restaurant chart. Subtitle is just a little line right below, so you could have more than one line there. The x-axis is already pretty much defined. In the y-axis, we're going to call this number sold. And the legend, you can put it at the left, right, top, or bottom. We're going to leave it on the right. You can display grid lines. We're just going to leave the Y, and we're going to say finished. So here it is with the stores at the bottom and the steak, pasta, vegetarian in the legend. Our number sold kind of shows the numbers here. We showed how to change the legend and the colors all in the previous video, so we're not going to go over that again, but I will copy this, or cut. I'm using Control X. Now I'm going to Sheet 2, Control, I'm going to just paste it with the shortcut menu. Now that it's here, I've got the green, and I want to stretch this out just to make it fill the page a little better. So there's my first restaurant chart. For our next chart, we want to select the meals again. Now, I'm holding down Control, and I'm highlighting our store 1, 2, and 3 under the income. Now, when I hit the chart, creates a new chart. I'm just going to jump right to finish here. And we can see that the dollar signs showed up for how much money came in for each meal by restaurant. So what I'm showing in this example is that the data doesn't have to be right next to each other. You can highlight some and then hold down control and highlight some more data and create another chart.